I think it's time to blow this scene. Get everybody in the stuff together. Okay, 3, 2, 1, let's jam.
All right, boys. Let's talk about Netflix's live-action remake? Reboot? Adaptation? Of the seminal Cowboy Bebop anime. It is a mixed bag for me, personally. I'm only a few episodes in, and I can't decide whether I like it, hate it, or I'm somewhere in between. On one hand, I love the casting of the main trio of John Cho's Spike, Mustafa Shakir's Jet Black, and Daniel Pineda's Faye. They do a great job of bringing these characters to life, and on the other hand, some of the writing and directing leaves me scratching my head. John Cho does a good job as Spike Spiegel. He gets the feeling of the man down, noodles first, and the style of his outfit is a perfect live-action version of Spike's anime look. He has that playfulness that Spike has and the more serious undertones of a man who was broken and betrayed by love and crime. He is, for the most part, an endearing character brought to life by a very competent actor. Excuse me. Mustafa Shakir's Jet Black can be a mixed bag, but overall I feel like he makes the role his own, yet keeps it faithful to the anime of an ex-cop turned bounty hunter who just wants to get his daughter a goddamn toy that's all the rage for her birthday. He and Cho's Spike have that fun, playful, love you, but also want to choke the life out of you relationship down, and my favorite episode so far that showcases this was probably the Teddy Bomber episode, which really let you get a feel for their partnership. Not to mention, he also has the look down. Daniel Pineda as Faye Valentine is perfect for me. She's tough, smart, and a pain in your ass. I really dig how Pineda has brought her to life in this rendition. She feels very accurate to her anime self, and please, see yourself out if you're going to whine about the costume or her physical attributes. There's the door. Don't let it hit your ass on the way out. Her introduction was fun, but forgive me, it's been a while since I rewatched Bebop proper, but I believe she was introduced much differently in the anime versus the live action, but that's not as glaring to me as it may be to some. As far as acting goes, Cho, Shakir, and Pineda do a good job with the material they are given. I would say my least favorite out of all the main characters right now is Vicious. As I saw on Twitter, somebody said Vicious is Geralt from The Witcher if he got into crypto, which somehow feels accurate. He doesn't feel super imposing, yet I definitely get the I'm crazy vibe from him. As I said, the main trio cast does a good job with what they are given, script and directing wise, yet I feel like the show would have been stronger with a stronger writing and directing team. I don't want to take shots at the cast or crew because I honestly believe nobody sets out to make a bad piece of content, I just personally feel there were choices made that should have been made differently. My main problem with the show is how it somehow simultaneously feels high and low budget and, what's the word, kitschy? Very kitschy? Like it's more cartoonish somehow than the anime at times? It's odd. I want so badly for the show to be good and for me to love it, but I can't commit to that. I feel like I'm very 50-50 on it for every episode. When it's just the characters talking and interacting, it feels good. When it's action, it feels decent. When it leads into this weird, almost slapstick angle, I find myself going, why did they make these choices? And no, I haven't seen Ed yet, but I have seen the stills of her, and, we will cross that bridge when we get to it. I don't think I need to bring up the music because it's a 10. Yoko Kanno came back and crushed it like she did with the OG, and the music of Bebop has and always will be one of the best soundtracks ever. Bless her for returning to grace us with her presence. The soulful and fun jazz is a staple of Bebop, and when she comes back like she never stepped away to begin with, you thank her for it. I plan on watching more of it and finishing this season, and we'll come back to this video and the article on my WordPress and update it with more thoughts about where I stand on it as a whole. But as for now, it really is 50-50. I love parts of it and hate other parts of it. Will that change? Who knows? But I will let you all know when I finish where it stands among the other adaptations of anime classics. I will give them this, though. It ain't nearly as bad as Death Note. And Netflix, I still haven't forgiven you for that one. Anyways, until later. See you, Space Cowboy.